I really want to welcome you here. What you really hear is a state-of-the-art training complex. It's a new spring training facility for both major and minor league baseball. Although the Red Sox do not have a minor league team, they do have minor leaguers in here. I think there's going to be close to 100 ball players here during the course of spring training. This is the main park that we're going to be taking you through, but there's also six practice fields here. And where you park are going to be some soccer fields that are going to be used off-season by the kids around here as well. So this is really quite a place. I think you're going to really enjoy it here. So we're going to move on here. In fact, I was just talking to somebody, and there is a little bit of misnomer. Sometimes the people think that in Lee County that they're actually paying in the taxes. They aren't. Completely funded through the bed tax. So that's a really great thing. We'll talk a little bit about how much money is going to come out of that bed tax over the next 30 years, because that's what the lease is for the Red Sox for this facility. And they worked a deal to get out of the city of Palm Ponds a little bit earlier on their lease there to move in here. And as you know, for some of you who live in this area, they're trying to get another team right now into City of Palm Park. And I know one team they're interested in right now is the Washington Nationals, which would be an interesting team because they're actually starting to invest in some key players, so it should be kind of cool. But anyway, I don't want to slow anything down, so I'm going to be kind of walking in here. Now, what I'm going to suggest is when you walk in here, just take it all in. You know, it's really kind of magnificent when you see this.
You would, but your daughter said no. Who has more influence? Your daughter? Well, her daughter paid for the ticket, so she does not want to admit she's not part of Red Sox Nation.
Yeah, Yankees!
I knew I was going to antagonize her so she would do this to me. Now I'm going to be in trouble. I'm only kidding. Anyway, I want to really kind of move on here so we get up to walk on the field. That's a special treat right there, so follow me. It's 231 feet long, which is the same identical length as the Green Monster in Fenway Park in Boston. Same length. It's 9,933 square feet. The entire wall. A pretty darn good sized wall, isn't it? Okay, and then as we go down, we're going to be looking at the manual scoreboard. We'll talk a little bit more about that. But this is all padded. We haven't run the line down yet, so there is going to be a little space. You can see where they've got it. There's going to be a little space, but very little. Probably less, I think, than Fenway Park in terms of what you can do as far as getting a ball. And so you can see that. So this is right the same dimensions. Okay. Waited all these many years. It was actually removed and stored in South Dakota. And they always thought that this is a piece of history. So you don't let history just go away. So they always thought if they ever did anything at a new park, they would put this in. So when they started to do it, they did, you know, they looked at all the situation here and they said, wait, we're going to be building. And they built a lot of design of this entire park around making sure this fit in. Now, look at this. Doesn't this look like you're in a bunker? This is actually where the people looked. They looked out to see if the inning was over so they could post the score, because in Fenway Park you can post the score behind, whereas here you can't. You have to physically come out and post the score up here.
They were behind.
Yeah, they're going to have something to reach them. Yeah, raise, get up an additional 6 feet in order to do it. So the bottom of that is 37 feet 2 inches. The bottom of that, above the top. Touching me. That's actually the regulation out of what you can see in Fenway Park. That's a great question. Tom and Gene Cockey, who owned the team, I understand, from 1933 to 1993, 60 years. Great benefactor, tremendous charity. Had picnics here every Sunday, or not here, but in Fenway Park in Boston, every Sunday. And what do you think this is right here?
Morse code, maybe?
It is. It's Morse code. It's for Thomas Austin Yawkey and Gene Remington Yawkey. It's their initials in Morse code. So what we've really preserved here is another whole part of history of Fenway Park, and the longest single owner of the Red Sox during that year. So, isn't that kind of cool?
Yeah.
You know, I never knew that until we were in here 2 weeks ago, and so you pointed that out. So, it's kind of a, you know, a great experience to see all of this and think about all
the 502 feet. That's the longest home run ever hit in Fenway Park. That was hit in 1946. Okay, it hit off a Detroit pitcher. 502 feet, and that's what that red seat represents. That's, and it's still the longest one to this day. Nobody's ever hit one.